Welcome to First United Baptist Church this morning on Palm Sunday. Lots of hosannas today. We're back at the end of the service, but I think you'll lose count, probably. We are glad you're here. We hope you read all of the announcements in the bulletin this busiest week, or one of the busiest weeks of the year for church. We have Monday, Thursday, and Good Friday services are here. Of course, Easter Sunday services, prayer, vigil, Easter egg hunt, all sorts of stuff that you can find in the bulletin. So, why don't we stand back up and greet each other?
Day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and give thanks to Him.
glad you did. Save us, we beseech you, O Lord. O Lord, we beseech you, give us success. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. The Lord is God, and he has given us life. Bind the festal procession with branches up to the horns of the altar. You are my God, and I will give thanks to you. You are my God, and I will extol you. O give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures forever.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, as very little sleep looks like this morning. I had a friend say to me, wow, you are really happy in the morning. I stayed at Austin's place last night, so I'm like jacked up on a little less than kosher sleep, so we're gonna have some fun this morning. Okay, so we've been around long enough that I think a lot of you know me, that did you guys know I like superheroes? Yeah, totally love superheroes. Love Star Wars, but you know, I've kind of branched off from Star Wars, and I've been known to dress up as superheroes on occasion. I have a couple costumes in my basement, and so I was thinking about superheroes, right? And you guys, I like that you guys have your moms, because, no, I'm not going to pick on you, don't worry. But you guys came in waving your palms, right? And so why do you think we do that? I know it's Palm Sunday. But why do you think we really, really do that? Anybody have an idea? So you guys just do this every year and you don't even know why? Oh my goodness, we're gonna talk about it then. Do you know the word that we've been hearing all morning, Hosanna? Hosanna, 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 Hosanna. So does anybody know what that word means? Do you think it means hooray for God? Do you think it means that? Hooray for Jesus. No, I got a head nod. I got a shake. I got a few shakers and a few nodders. Well, that's what the people said when Jesus came into town, right? And that's why we celebrate Palm Sunday, because Jesus made his triumphant entrance into town. But Hosanna really means save us, because the people wanted to be saved, right? And what kind of person would you think would save you? Jesus? Well, Jesus, yeah, Jesus does save us, but like if, oh, go ahead. Your parents, well, that's when they think they'd save you, that's wonderful. I like to think that if someone was going to save me, it might be like a superhero, right? Yeah, so I've got these really fun things today. Do you guys see these? One says, amazing. It's like, and it looks kind of like cartoony, like you'd see in a Superman cartoon. One says incredible, star, and there's terrific. So I'm going to put these back in the bag, and I want you each to take one. And these are erasers. So these are kind of fun, aren't they? Are you going to pick? Which one do you think you're going to pick? Star? Okay, yeah, because you're a superstar. I started thinking about, hey, Jeff, you want to pass these around for me? I started thinking about how, around, you take one and then pass them for me. I started thinking about how incredible, and I thought all these words describe Jesus. He's a star, incredible. What else was in there? Terrific. And that's kind of what the people on Palm Sunday thought of Jesus, right? They thought, he's amazing. Look, here he comes. He's going to save us. He's a star. He's all these wonderful things, right? But what happens later in the week? Do you guys know what happens later in the week? What happens? We have a thing. Go ahead, Sarah. He gets crucified. We have Good Friday, and then he died. But then he rose from the dead by next Sunday. This all happens in the same week. And so on that very Sunday today that we're talking about Jesus being a star and incredible and amazing, by the end of the week, they are killing Jesus and crucifying him to save him. And get, oh, thank you, thanks, I needed one too. And so I started thinking about how Jesus, they wanted Jesus to come and save them. They thought he'd come and save them with some big army, or come and save them by, taking down the government, okay? But Jesus didn't do any of those things. Do you know how Jesus saved us? He died for us, and he erased all our sins. That's what he did. And so while we can think of Jesus this way, and we can think he's terrific, he is terrific. But he didn't come and be terrific in the way that they thought he was going to come and be terrific. He came in a totally different way. And he has come and come and come and come time and time again if we invite him into our hearts and ask him to help us be forgiven and erase everything that we've done. So will you guys have a word of prayer with me? Dear God, thank you for sending Jesus to people like us
We know that you love us because you sent Jesus to erase all our sins. And we ask you to be with us this week as we celebrate Palm Sunday and the walk to the grave, and we rejoice next Sunday for Easter. Amen. Thanks, guys.
Next is the ministry one.
This year, our church will again be participating in a prayer vigil the weekend of Easter. The last several years, we've been praying for peace in the chapel right adjacent to the sanctuary. Our prayer vigil will start at 1 o'clock p.m. on Good Friday and will end at 1 o'clock p.m. on Saturday, March 31st. You can simply come in and pray your own prayers. Or there will also be binders provided that have prayers for peace in them. There will also be prayer stations available to participate in. We'd love you to join us. It's been a really moving experience the last several years to participate. You will find in the Friendship Center today a sign-up board. So please put your name in one of those one-hour time slots and pray with us this coming weekend. Love to have you join us. Thanks to you, ministering is in motion at First United Methodist Church.
As we continue to say Hosanna, ask God to save us, we also sometimes need to be saved from our money, I think. It's too important. But we want to thank God for the gifts that He gives us, so we do that by receiving our offering. Please stand.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, your love makes me sing, your Some of you might wonder, did you bring your coin box? What do you call those? It's coin bag. Let's shake those for a minute, would you? Shake them. How louder? There we go. Good. That's what I asked for right there. The reason I said that is so I can set this up and to tell you that you ought to bring those forward at the last song. Okay? So you're thinking, okay, I've been holding on to this. When should I shake it during the sermon? And when do I take it up? So shake it anytime you want to during the sermon and bring it up during the last song. All right. Do that again. Shake them again. No, really. Okay. It's a little weak, but. I don't want to overdo it. All right. When they were approaching Jerusalem at Bethphage and Bethany, near the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it." If any notice, Jesus said, "Bring it." That just hit me for the first time. "If anyone says to you, 'Why are you doing this?' just say this, 'The Lord needs it and will send it back here immediately.'" They went away and found a colt tied near a door outside in the street. As they were untying it, some of the bystanders said to them, "What are you doing, untying the colt?" They told them what Jesus had said, and they allowed them to take it. Then they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks on it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut in the fields. Then those who went ahead and those who followed were shouting, "Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest heaven." Then he entered Jerusalem and went into the temple. And when he had looked around at everything, as it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. This is the word of God. Thanks be to God. So I remember a story. I can't remember where I heard it exactly, but it was a story about a gentleman who was getting up in years, and he had a strain to hear, and his eyesight was starting to fail, and it took him a little while to get up in the morning and get his breakfast and get cleaned up and put on his clothes. But every Sunday, he made it to church. He got up, fixed his breakfast, got himself cleaned up and dressed up, and he walked all the way to church every Sunday. And somebody said, "Why?" He could barely hear the music. He could barely hear the preaching. It was virtually a full day's work to get ready in the morning, let alone make a trek to worship with limited eyesight. And so the person said, "Is it worth it? Why do you do it?" And the man said to him, "I do it because I want it to be clear whose side I am on." So there is no doubt this morning that Palm Sunday crowd is on Jesus' side. There's something about Jesus, and they love Jesus, and they're praising God, and they all want to make no bones about whose side they are on. Now, we need to know that this is not the same crowd that shouted "Crucify Him" on Friday. Some folks have made the mistake, and I know I've been among them, of talking on about how enthusiastic and loyal and committed those crowds were on Sunday, but that by Friday those same crowds had turned their backs on Jesus and begun to sing a crucifixion song, as it were. But that's not true. Ordinary people like the ones who accompanied Jesus along that route of entry into Jerusalem that day didn't have access to Pilate's courtyard. So it was a different crowd on Friday. It is, however, true that this crowd is confused about what it means for Jesus to be Messiah. They expect a conquering king. They expect that Jesus will do something right now. They expect that he will finally overthrow the Roman government and put Israel back in charge of its own affairs. And you and I, we might be about as confused about Jesus sometimes. The folks who assure us that Jesus is coming back next week may be just as confused about Jesus. The ones who turn Jesus and God into cosmic tyrants eager to send us all to hell may be just as confused about Jesus. And you and I might be guilty of knowing far less about Jesus than we ought to. But let's forget about all that just for today, because at least somebody's cheering. It might be a good time to shake hands. Okay, somebody's cheering. And they know that Jesus is here to love, and they know that Jesus is here to save, and so they shout, Hosanna! Which means, save us or save now. They are right about who, if not entirely so about how. They know he's on their side, and they know that they are on his side, Jesus' side. And there's something about a parade that loosens people up, right? Gets everybody excited and kind of giddy and happy. And there's something about this Palm Sunday thing. This Palm Sunday parade that's got people all wound up and running around half nuts and shouting as if nobody's watching. Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest heaven. And then they shook their coin bags. Right. Now, is it possible they've forgotten about themselves for just a minute? I remember an old song. It was kind of, the music was a little hokey, I think, in my opinion, which made the words seem hokey also, which probably shouldn't have been. But the words say, let's forget about ourselves and praise the Lord. And I wonder, isn't that what worship really is, at least in great part? And I wonder, can you and I do that? Can we forget about our busy lives and our busy schedules and our problems and our phones and our texting and really praise God? Can we remember how much God loves us? Can we recall that no matter who we are, no matter where we've been, and no matter what we've done, and no matter how sunny or gloomy or snowy or icky our circumstances might be, or it might be outside, there's nothing we can do to make God love us.